Hello, welcome to session 3 of The Nature of Code, Intelligence and Learning. So this is one of my opening videos for these sessions. If you are watching this video as part of that playlist for the Intelligence and Learning course, you will see a lot of videos in front of you with a variety of demonstrations and different coding challenges. There will also be a video at the end where I come back and pose some ideas for an exercise or assignment that you could try. But what I want to do in this particular video is now is the time. This course has sort of started with this little warm-up of thinking about artificial intelligence and search algorithms and graph systems. And then we took this turn and thought about genetic algorithms and evolutionary systems. But you might be here because you heard about this term machine learning, maybe even heard about this term deep learning, and you want to get a sense of what does that mean? What are the possibilities with machine learning and deep learning? How do machine learning systems work? What are they for? What's the lingo for this sort of stuff? And now's the time to get into that. Now, session 3 here, I will not be using any neural network yet. So what I want to do in session 3 is just talk about what machine learning is, what its applications are. So something that I'm going to cover here is classification and regression. What do those terms mean? And what are some classic algorithms for performing classification and regression? And so I'm going to look at something called nearest neighbor similarity, K nearest neighbor, and I'm also going to look at something called linear regression. And so these will be some sort of classic algorithms that you can play around with and do stuff with, and then in session 4, we'll start looking at what a neural network is and see how we can use that as part of a machine learning system. Okay, are you with me? By the way, I barely know about any of this stuff. So if you're watching this for an expert, you probably want to find somebody else on YouTube. But I'm learning this stuff, trying it out, and hopefully you're going to come along and join me on the train, right? Oh, I forgot, we're on the train. On this ride on the train in the sky with me as your guide. Do sky and guide rhyme? I think they do. You'll see. I had a point to this, but I digress. Okay, so what is machine learning? So first of all, one thing that I might suggest for you if you want to watch some videos about somebody who really knows what they're talking about, I would suggest Andrew Ng's Coursera course. A lot of my knowledge and inspiration has come from that course. And Andrew Ng does a good job of giving a nice introduction to machine learning and 2 particular references. One is this definition, this quote from Arthur Samuels, who is a pioneer in the world of machine learning, defining machine learning as a field of study that gives computers the ability to learn without being explicitly programmed. And so here's an interesting thing we can think about. When we looked at the A-star algorithm in session 1 for pathfinding, we were designing us, the programmer, writing an algorithm to specifically perform a task. The computer would follow those instructions and get to a result. There was an intelligence to that algorithm. There was this appearance of sort of the computer solving a problem and thinking about it. But ultimately, we had written the instructions, the code for the computer to solve to arrive at an answer. So what if instead of us writing the instructions, we would just set up a framework for the computer to figure out what the instructions might be, what are the right parameters for some type of model to perform some sort of task. So this is the idea of machine learning. And I would encourage you to look at the work of Arthur Samuels. One of the things that he did was train a computer to learn to play checkers by just having it play itself over and over and over again, thousands of times, to be able to learn what a good strategy was. So one of the things that I want to talk about here is, so let me come over to the whiteboard here. I have this README that I'll link to in the description. You can read some of the definitions and information that's on that README. But what I want to look at is this model for this. I'm going to describe to you machine learning in this particular way. So there is some sort of input. That input is going to go into some sort of algorithm, some recipe. I think that's a nice way of thinking about it. Some machine learning recipe. And then out of that machine learning recipe, we are going to get an output. The input into the machine learning recipe is typically numeric. So you could think of it as, you know, a classic example that's always given is, what if we want to build a machine learning system that can guess the price of a house based on some inputs? So maybe we might say something like, oh, the house has 3 bedrooms, and it has 2 bathrooms, and it has 1,000 square feet, and et cetera, et cetera. This is the input into the machine learning recipe, and the output might come, the house is, you know, $1 million. Something like that. Nice house, apparently. Okay, so this is what machine, so typically speaking, another way of thinking about machine learning is making sense of data. So I have some sort of data and I want to make sense of it, have some input and some output. So two kinds of output that you'll see in most machine learning algorithms are classification. Another kind of output is regression. So what you might not have realized here is this example that I gave to you where the parameters of a house, a data point, goes into the machine learning recipe and we get this price output, this is actually regression. Regression refers to predicting some sort of continuous numeric output. Whereas classification refers to taking an input and classifying it into a discrete set of labels. So here might be another scenario. I have an image of a cat. That is the input into the machine learning recipe, and the output is something like this. I'm getting, usually the output comes at numeric, so we have to sort of figure out what this could mean, but you know, I'm speaking in kind of higher level terms here, so I'm just gonna say the output is cat. I am labeling it. And maybe the only possible options are cat versus dog. So what that output actually is something like, you know, 0.9, 0.1. Like there's a 90% chance this is a cat, 10% chance it's a dog. So this is classification attempting to assign a discrete label to something like an image. We could have done something with the house data using the classification. We could say, you know, fancy house, you know, summer house, winter house. You know, we could classify into one of two categories. That's classification. Regression, getting a continuous numeric output. So how does this work? So number one is we've got to at some point start talking about what are some different recipes that could go in here. And I could name you a few. For example, K nearest neighbor. This is a particular algorithm that can work for both classification and regression. I could say something like support vector machine, or I could say artificial neural network. And then there are a variety of flavors, so to speak, of styles and of artificial neural networks, convolutional neural network, recurrent neural network. So this is something I ultimately intend to spend a lot of time on. What is an artificial neural network? How does it work? And why is it effective to put it in here? But even with all of the amazing innovation that's happening in machine learning and deep learning right now, there's a lot that you can do without artificial neural networks. A lot of simple, fun exercises and things. So in this particular session three, I'm going to look at other algorithms that are non-artificial neural network, non-neural network based, that become the machine learning recipe, like k-nearest neighbor. But let's take a moment here to talk about how overall this works. Because the thing is, this doesn't just happen magically. You can't just, you know, the point of doing this is that at some day, we might want to put an unknown image in here and get a classification label for that image. But how can a machine learning recipe do that from nothing? And it can't. So one of the things I want to talk about here is how does this work? So before you can actually use machine learning to make predictions for unknown data, you need to train the system. So the training step involves, so there are several different strategies for how a machine learning system can learn in order to perform operations like this. One is called supervised learning. And supervised learning is the strategy that I'm going to use in just about everything that I do in this particular course from session three right now and on, although I will come back to some other techniques as well. Another kind of learning is unsupervised learning. And another kind of learning that I really love, my favorite kind of learning, is reinforcement learning. In fact, I have a whole book all about reinforcement learning that I'm reading right now. Okay, so what are these different, and you know, there's something called semi-supervised learning, and there's little variations on this, but these are three core types of learning that can be applied to the machine learning process. Let's start with reinforcement learning for a second. Reinforcement learning is a kind of learning where an agent observes the environment and chooses an action. You can think of a mouse trying to get through a maze. The mouse looks around, there's a wall here, there's a wall here, there's a wall here. The mouse decides to go left, the mouse decides to go right. And then once the mouse makes that decision, the mouse receives a reward. And that could be a positive or negative reward. And you know, as the mouse receives more positive rewards for certain kinds of actions, it does more of those actions over the long term and gets better and better at things. So that's reinforcement learning. I'm gonna spend a whole session looking at this at some point, and we're gonna see some techniques. I have an example that uses a kind of reinforcement style learning to train, to autonomously play the game Flappy Bird. Okay, unsupervised learning is a kind of learning that's generally applied to data that you know nothing about. So, I have 100,000 songs, and I just want to kind of learn, like, what patterns are there in the songs? So typically, unsupervised learning is applied to problems like clustering. So I have all this data, and I want to kind of figure out, how can this data be arranged in groups? Could I have and I don't know anything about it. Could an algorithm figure out, based on patterns in the data, how to group that data, how to cluster that data? So I don't know that this is something that I'm going to spend any time. It's not on my current trajectory / syllabus, but it is something that I would like to do at some point in the future. And there's actually some ideas for some stuff I want to do about that eventually. Okay, but here, we're going to give a nice little star and a heart and a little smiley face and like a little rainbow for supervised learning, because this is what I'm going to use in most of my examples over the next several videos. The idea of supervised learning is I have training data. So number one, I have training data. Number two, I have test data. And number three, I have the rest of the world universe of data. So maybe we could call this unknown data. So how does this work? So first, what we do in supervised learning is we take this training data. We have a huge database of a spreadsheet of bedrooms, bathrooms, and square footage for houses with their actual price that they sold at. So we have a data set that has the parameters and some sort of target, often called a target. So this would be like the training data with the inputs and a target. The idea is the inputs go into the machine learning recipe, they come out the other side, and some sort of guess is made. Maybe the house actually sold for $1.5 million, but the guess was $1 million. Ah, so the machine learning recipe got it wrong. So we turn some knobs here and mess around with it to try to get it to have a better result that's towards what that error is. So we're going to talk a lot about this error and that sort of thing. We're going to come back to this many, many times. So we do this over and over again with lots and lots of training data, turning all the knobs, trying to get it to do a good job. Then what we do is we have test data. Now test data is just like the training data. It's data that has inputs with a known result that we should get. But we didn't actually use it while training because we have this issue. A machine learning recipe might perform really, really well with the training data, but not with actual other data. So to see how well it's working, we've actually got to give it data that we didn't use to train, and that's called the test data. So we would feed that, see how well it does, evaluate the performance and say like, you know what? It got all the test data right, it's ready, it's all grown up, our machine learning recipe is ready to go, and we send it out into the world to start interacting with unknown data. So this is really the process. This is supervised learning. It's saying, hey, I'm the teacher. This is the machine learning system. I'm going to teach the system with my known data, with known output. I'm going to test the data with separate known inputs and known outputs. And then it's going to be all grown up. It's going to graduate. I'm going to send it out into the world and yada, yada, yada. You know, more, by the way, I plan on doing a lot of yada, yada, yada neural network stuff. Like, we might get to like, and then you have to do this like calculus thing, yada, yada, yada. I think that's a good practice to yada, yada, yada machine learning as much as possible. Okay, so that's a brief introduction to what machine learning is overall and what some of the sort of key aspects of how a machine learning system works. We're going to get into a lot more about the details here, and we're going to look at a variety of different kinds of recipes that can be put in here and how they work with different kinds of data, like which recipe do you want to work with images, which recipe would you want for working with text, for this kind of classification, for this kind of regression. But right now, I'm going to move on and start looking at nearest neighbor. What is this thing called nearest neighbor? How can I look at two different pieces of data. So I have a bunch of pre-made examples in some of the, if you follow along with the playlist, you're going to see a bunch of examples where I code stuff from scratch, but I'm not going to do a video for every single one of these examples. I mean, maybe I will someday, but for the first thing that I'm really going to start looking at is, and this is an example inspired by, Rebecca Fiebrink, who has a wonderful course called, I think, Machine Learning for Musicians and Artists from the company Cadenze. I'll put a link to that in this video's description, where she uses a tool that she built called Wekinator to do classification and regression and a variety of other things. So she does a lot of stuff with gestural interfaces and musical output. So one of the things I want to look at, and I'm going to hit play here, and what you're going to see is, as I move the mouse near a particular note, the note changes. C, D, E, F. And this is actually a classification. This is an example of classification. What I'm doing is I have two-dimensional data, a Cartesian coordinate system, and I want to classify every X, Y point to a particular note. This is classification. So the nearest note is the note that I play. I can actually switch this example to perform regression. And this is an example now of regression. You can hear I make a prediction based on a weighted distance. So here I essentially have an average of C and G. I'm hearing a little G. I'm at a frequency between G and C. And you can hear G, C, G, C. So these are the kind of examples that I want to build to get you started with understanding the algorithms and have some ideas for some creative possibilities that you can do. And then we're going to just keep going. So stay tuned. There'll be a bunch of videos in this playlist where I go through a few different examples and scenarios. I'll come back with another video with some homework ideas, and hopefully you'll make some stuff and share it with me and live your life in this world/universe/place, and maybe give somebody a hug or say something nice to somebody, because those are good things to do too. Okay, see you in a future video.